So today we are going to see security, and mostly we have seen dimensions, data forms, and apart from that we have seen smart list and some other properties in it. So let us log into our existing planning application. So to log into existing planning application, we'll use this URL logon.jsp, and our application is Asia Currency. Let's say passport. After providing this particular password in administrations, we have seen this application settings, view statistics, reporting, alias tables, manage properties. In manage properties, we are not going to change anything, only we are setting your supporting details cache we are increasing. Where do we get the supporting details? We get supporting details in data forms. And in this data form, I think we have created with this for few accounts. So in this, we have created a supporting detail. How do we create this? Whenever you double click on this cell, automatically you will be getting the supporting details. This we have done. Now, today we are going to discuss about this particular topic called as security. So if you see at the bottom, we are having something called as manage security filters. Okay, when is your security filter created? Mostly when we create a security filter, it will be created. But nowhere you are having a option called as manage users, because from planning application onwards, planning users are not created in your planning application. There is no such option to create users in planning itself. So where can we create those users? Means you have to create your users in shared services. So to log into your shared services, where is this? I don't have this. Let me go into this administrator and directly say manage users, user management. When I click on this user management, automatically it will take me to shared services. So I have logged into my shared services. Now let me, in this, if I want to create planning users, I'll expand this. And in native directory, I'll right click on my user and I'll say new user. Okay, so let us create some 4 or 5 users on this. Say PL1 and password is password. Let's say finish. This is already user is there. P1 user, I think this is also there. P1 user got created, let us create another user. P2 user. So this way I have created all my 4 users, say P1, P2, P3, P4. So let me say if I want to have users starting with P, I can do a wildcard search also. P star, if I say search, will display all users starting with P. In this P1, P2, P3, P4 are my users. So now I'll right click on this user and I'll say provisioning. As we did in your SBase, we are doing this also in your planning. When I say provision, okay, when I say provision, so before we used to provision users on ASBase, but right now users, we have to provision them on planning. So to provision them on planning, where is your planning application available? Your planning application is available under your default application. When I expand them, I'll be able to see all these applications. So in this, my application is Asia Currency application. Let me expand this Asia Currency. these are the roles available under your planning application. You will have something called as queue creator, analytical service write access, mass allocation, offline user, view user, planner, interactive user, manage models, administrator, provisional manager. Provisional manager and administrator, you know, provisional manager, he can create administrators, and at the same time, administrator can do all these activities below whatever these users are having. And apart from this, manage models, you need not know, most of the time we will not be having this manage models, and mostly we'll be going with interactive users and planners. So we mostly use, I'll select all of them. Most of the times we use a role called as planner or interactive user. So what is a planner? Planner is a user who can input data into your web forms, who can also run business rules, who can also participate in your workflow process. All these things we didn't discuss, but just remind, planner is a user who can input data into your web forms, and at the same time he can run business rules, and he can also participate in workflow management. Okay, this is about your planner. What is your interactive user? Interactive user is a user who can create web forms also. He can create web forms. Whatever we created web forms yesterday, those forms he can create. And all other activities he can do. As a planner, whatever roles planner has, with that roles, the extra work that interactive user can do is he can create web forms. A portion of administration activities will be available for your interactive user. Planner, interactive user, view user is nothing but a read user. He can just read only. He can do read only. Offline user, say for example, if your particular laptop is removed from network, and if you are going in a flight and you want to perform, in meanwhile if you want to perform, you can take this particular application into, not this application, web forms into offline. This particular offline user is not available from your 11.1.2 onwards. It is not that much flexible, so we are not going to use this. So mass allocation, we are not going to allocate to any of the user. Only analytical server write access means, if a user want to input data from Excel add-in or SmartView, from SBS database point of view, user want to input data, we will be providing him with an access called as analytical server access. Analytical services, right? Say if you are an administrator, because I am an administrator, I am an administrator, from where I am loading my data? With a rule file. Can I load my data into a planning application? I can load my data only into SBS application, right? So, for that I should have some access, right? Otherwise, I cannot load my data into my SBS database. So, from lower level, I can see this Asia currency application. Now, I want to load data into this Asia expense. So, what I'll do? Right click on this and I'll say create rule file and I'll load this data. Same way, there are some admin users from user end also. For them, I cannot provide administration access. Just for data loading purpose, I cannot provide him administration access. If I provide him an administration access, by for some reason, say without knowing, he might delete my outline. He might delete. So for that reason, what we will do is we will provide him with analytical services write access, so that what he can do, he can connect to an Excel sheet. He can open an Excel sheet. And he can perform lock and send from here. Say, right now, let me give this particular user as a planner. P1 user as a planner. And if I say save, this particular user is having access on your planning application. Same ways, P2 user, I am selecting him and I am provisioning him and I am giving him interactive user. Asia currency. Interactive user. Okay. I said okay. P3 is a user to which I'm giving only view user access. I'm giving him view user access. Okay. P4 is a user. Right click on this. Provision. I'm giving him analytical service write access, planner access also. Say from planning he should be a planner, from SBase he should be having a write access. With this, this will not be sufficient. If I want to log into my SBase database, what I should have? I should have write access, at least server access to that particular SBase database. So what I'll be doing? I'll be giving server access. Because this user is trying to lock and send from SBase database, what I'm doing? I'm giving him server access. Because they have to enter into your SBase database. And say save. Okay. With this, I have defined this many users, P1, P2, P3, P4. Now if I go to this, I'm able to see only my admin in this particular user list. Okay. What I'll do is, I'll just do a sync native directory or recover native directory. When I say recover native directory, start recovery. So this particular thing has to recover things. So all this information will be written into a file, password file, from where again your planning application has to pull it into your SBase database. So it got completed. Next thing I'll do is, what I'll do is, I'll go to administrator and I'll say manage database. And in this, if you see, there is something called as security filter. So I'll say refresh. Means I'm asking them to create a security filter. When I say refresh, this starts creating your security filters onto your SBase database application. Right click, edit, filters. If you see, plan 1, 2, 3, 4 users are getting created. When I open them, they will be having none access. P1 is having none access. P2 is having none access. P3 is having none access. P4 is having none access. Though I provided P4 and SBase write access, but still he is having only group called as none. I am not having write or read groups. Why this is? Because I have to create this particular filter. So this got completed. Now let me go into my planning and let me go to minus security filters and see, I am able to see my P1, P2, P3, P4 users. But these users are having access only onto your planning application. But into your planning application, again there are secured components in your planning application. Your dimensions are your members are secure. Mostly your dimensions are secured in planning application. Means if I go to dimensions, if I select on any one member, I am getting assign access control. Means my dimension members are secured in planning application. The same way, if I go to data forms, if you see, that will disturb. Okay, assign access. So your data forms are having access control. Means even your data forms are secure. Dimensions are secure. Data forms are secure. Same ways. Let me click on my task list. When I click on my task list, if you see, if we have created any task list, that is also having assign access. Means even your task lists are secure. And apart from this, your business rules are also secure. So totally, data dimensions are secure, data forms are secure, and apart from that, your task lists are secure, your business tools are secure. And from 11.1.3 onwards, from 11.1.3 onwards, let us create one folder and see, I'm just cross-checking one thing. Okay, from 11.1.3 onwards, your data form folders are also becoming as secure. Before this version 9.3, from 9.3 version, we never used to have this assign access. Only from your 11 version, even your data form folders are secure. task list are secure, task list folders are not secure, data forms are secure, data form folders are secure, and at the same time dimensions are secure, and your business rules are secure. These many things are secure. Okay. Now let us go into first thing that is called as your dimensions. Always, whenever if you want to work on any web forms, if you are providing a user access on web form, he will not have access on this web form until and unless he is defined, his security is defined on his members. And members mean the first you should have, you should provide security, then only you can provide security on your web forms. If you are providing web form security and you are not providing member security, then he can see that web form, but when he opens that web form, nothing will be displayed. Okay, so for that, what we have to do? We have to first provide security on dimensions. Okay, in dimensions, all dimensions are not secure. Only four dimensions are secure. So what are those four dimensions? Your account dimension is secure. Now you can see assign access. Same way, your entity dimension is secure. Assign access, and your scenario and version dimensions are also secure. Scenario, assign access control, version, assign access control. Means in planning, four dimensions are secure. Whether it is a currency dimension or non-currency dimension, whatever may be, only your four dimensions are secure in nature. What are those? Accounts, scenarios, entities, and versions are secure dimensions. Apart from this, if you want to create a dimension in your planning application, custom dimension. I am not satisfied with this particular seven dimensions. I want to create a new dimension. Whenever I say add dimension, if I provide my dimension name as legal entity, and after providing this, before saving this, I can enable my security on my custom dimensions. If I click this button, my dimension will have security. If I unclick this, my dimension will not have security. Means your custom dimensions can be optionally selected whether if you want to provide security or not. So altogether, what all are secured means accounts, scenarios, entities, versions, and your customs can be secured, and they can also not be a secure dimension. But whenever you are creating a dimension, think that once you are creating your dimension, it cannot be deleted. From front end, you will not have an option to delete your dimensions. Nowhere you will get an option to delete your dimension. So from back end, from tables, you can go to your tables and delete your dimension, but that is not recommended. Mostly you should not be deleting a dimension. Once it is created, you cannot delete a dimension. Okay. So now let us go to account dimension and let us create a security. So under account, the first parent, whatever the first childrens are there, whatever childrens are there, childrens of accounts should be provided with security. On account dimension, you cannot provide security. On a dimension level, you cannot provide security. Say account is having 10,000 members, you have to go to on each and every member and provide security on each and every member. Clear? So right now I want to provide access to account 001. I'll say assign access. Now here no user is having access. Right now we didn't define anything. I'll say add access. When I say add access, who all users are having access on this, they will be displayed. I'll select all of them. Control, catch everyone. What types of accesses we can provide? We can provide read, write, and none access. Now I'm going to provide him write access on this particular account. And in case in future, if any children are going to be added to this particular account, I'll say include descendants. I'll say add. I want to provide access on this particular member, and I also want to provide access to the children that are going to be created in future. The account in the future will create kaboy account lukani kavali ante, what type of access I will provide? When I say view, I will be able to see this particular member access, descendants, including descendants. Okay, so these ways I have to provide to each and every account. Assign access, add access. Say write access and say add. So whenever you provide access, you will be able to see something called as view. Means this particular user is provisioned with security. So I'll go to assign access. So there is no other way. If there are 10,000 members present under your account dimension, you have to go to each and every member and define the security. Mostly to provide security, not web form. Whenever you want to provide security, you can do this. Okay. So let us create on each and every member, assign access. They should have at least provided this option. Ila control button select chesthe vastunna kada user, same way for members also they should have given this opportunity. When I click this and if I select control, it should have been taken. అలాంటి ఫెసిలిటీ ఇవ్వలేదు. సో టు ఎవ్రీ వన్ ఐఎమ్ హ్యావింగ్ రైట్ యాక్సెస్. వై ఐఎమ్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ రైట్ యాక్సెస్ మీన్స్ బికాస్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిఫైన్డ్ పీ వన్ యాజ్ ఎ డిఫరెంట్ యూజర్, పీ టూ యాజ్ ఎ డిఫరెంట్ యూజర్, పీ త్రీ యాజ్ ఎ డిఫరెంట్ యూజర్, పీ ఫోర్ యాజ్ ఎ. సో టు అండర్స్టాండ్ దేర్ రూల్స్ ఐఎమ్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ యాజ్ ఎ రైట్ యాక్సెస్. దో ఐ ప్రొవైడ్ రైట్ యాక్సెస్, స్టిల్ దే విల్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ రైట్ యాక్సెస్. You have to go to each and every dimension, four dimensions, all those four dimensions, and you have to, this is the serious task you have in planning. So add. No, you cannot provide access to your dimension. Assign access, add access, write access. So now my account dimension is done. So next thing I have to do is I have to go to my entity dimension. So when I go to my entity dimension, again assign access, add access, write. To everyone I am providing write access. SBase, you can write the filter name. Happily, you can edit your filter and you can start writing it. Okay. Access. Right. Almost. We'll complete it in like 2-3 minutes. Assign access. Normally in your 11, up till your 11 month, whenever in your real time if you click on add access, it takes somewhere around 20 minutes to display. 20 to 30 minutes. Add. So till 9.3.1 it was very serious task. Security is one of the toughest tasks that we used to have. So in this I provide only to actuals and budget, because actuals and budget only we are using in web forms. Say assign access, add access, budget, assign access, add access, write access. And I'll go to my version. So both of them I'll provide. Assign access, add access, write access, add. No other problem. It takes more than that. Assign access. Right. So right now we have provided access. Now if you see your filters, they are still the same. Even if I refresh, every filter will be none only. None only. So 1, 2, 3, 4 will be none in nature, but your 4 will have your write access in this. Let us see. But when this particular filters will be updated, I do a manage database, security, and say view. So now it is going to create your filters into your SBS database. So don't do this security refresh whenever you require. Whenever your business is down, in that point of time only do this security refresh. So now let me open my filters. Filters open basic. If I open one, your read access is there. Okay, I close this. If I open P4, this user will have write access also. Why this user is having write access? Because we have provided him analytical write access. Okay, say from SBS point of view, this is the scenario. Now let us go to our planning. Let me log off. And let me log in with Eva. And let me say password. I've provided my password, and if I say login, it throws an error saying that application is in maintenance mode, new logins are not allowed. Why is this? It is not allowing P1 to log into this particular planning application because administrator is logging, but P1, P2, P3, P4 users are not allowed to log in. Because if you remember in application settings, what did we do? We set only administrators to log into the application because this application is in maintenance mode. So now I logged in. I'll go to administrator, I'll go to application settings. In this, I'll set application maintenance mode, enable use of this application for only administrators. P1 is not an administrator, P2 is not an administrator, P3, P4 are not administrators. So what I'll do, I'll say allow all users, and I'll say okay. I'll log out and I'll log in. Though I have provided access, for P1, I'm not able to see any folders, data form folders, and at the same time I'm not able to see administration role for this P1. Why? Because user is not having any access on this. Okay, now let me log off and let me log in as admin. Okay, so now dimension level security we have secured. Now let me go to manage data forms. Okay, and I'll say assign access for this particular folder. I'll select this folder and I'll say assign access. When I say access, add access. So what type of access he should be having? P1, P2, P3, P4. I'll say all of them should have write access. And I'll say add. So close. So this user is having actual access, but budget he is not having access. And at the same time, in actual folder, I'll say to have access, to assign access, I'll say assign access, add access. In this, one more problem is there. If I select all of them and if I say assign access, you have multiple data forms selected. Even you can provide access only to one web form at a time. This is the problem that we are having. When I say assign access, add access, so what type of access this particular user should have? Say write access. Say add and say. So with this, I have provided my access. Let me log out. Now log in with P1. No. Now if you see, I am able to see forms. At the same time, I am able to see actuals. And in actuals, I am able to see all these folders. When I say open, I am able to input into this. But let me select this. Okay, because I have provided total write access on the particular web form folder. So all the web forms I am able to see. Now, let me log in as P2 and see. P2 is an interactive user. Let us see what all roles he will be getting as a P2. P2, password. Okay. I am able to see administrator role because he is an interactive user. And in this interactive user, he is not getting all properties. What all properties he is getting? He can manage data forms, he can manage task lists, he can manage menus, he can manage user variables, he can clear cells, he can create alias tables. These are the roles that your interactive user will have. So let me go to manage data forms, and in forms, he is having only actuals related. He can create composite forms, he can create normal waveforms, symmetric waveforms and all. Whereas planner cannot do all these things. Okay, now let us log off. And let us log in as P3, who is a view user. Okay, password. He is a view user. He is not having administrator role, forms, actuals. Though I have provided him write access, if you see, he is not able to write anything because he is a view user. Though you provide write access or planner access, and if you provide none access or read access on this particular folder, user will not have access. He will be able to read only. Even apart from that, you can make a web form as a readable form. In web form, we have made some columns as read-only columns. Same as total web form, you can restrict or you can make it as a read-only form. In how many ways you can restrict a user? Though you are providing him total access, total types of accesses at a shared services level, coming to planning, again you can restrict him at a folder level, again you can restrict him at a web form level, again in a web form, again you can restrict him at a column level, or you can make entire web form as a read only. In each order, you can restrict a user. Okay? So now, let us log into your Sbase application with help of P1. Connect P1 password. I'm able to see Asia currency, Asia expense. If I say OK and if I say retrieve, I'll be able to retrieve these things. If I say 100 and if I say Sbase log, it says you do not have sufficient. Okay, then if I say connect as P4 and if I provide password as password and if I like say lock will allow at a top level, because I don't have access on accounts, periods, years, scenarios, versions, currencies and entities. Where I'm having access? I'm having access on India, I'm having access on local, I'm having access on target, I'm having access on actual, I'm having access on FY11, January, and account AC_001 account. So now if I say Sbase lock, it gets locked. Whereas if I disconnect this user and if I connect with P1 password, if I say lock, it says you do not have sufficient. P1, P2, P3 cannot log into Sbase database because they don't have analytical server right now. Only your P4 user can log into this particular application. Okay, now what I'll do is, I want to see where my exchange rates are available. We have locked and send exchange rates from your is based from your planning application, right? How we have logged on since whenever you do a database refresh, automatically your exchange rates come populates into this particular SBase database. Now let me say retrieve. Okay, say entity, I'll keep entity as it is at a top level. Currency, I'll keep it at a top level. Version, I'll keep it at a top level. But scenario, I'll take actual scenario into consideration, because for actual and budget we have created two different tables. Let me keep budget only. Okay, and from version, I'm keeping my version as it is. Year, which year I have taken? I have taken FY11, FY12, FY13, FY14. So let me take all years or FY12 into consideration and say keep all. Okay, from period, because we are having many periods, let me put period as it is. And accounts, I'm putting accounts. In accounts, I'm taking only these accounts. You know, historical, average, ending rates. So in this, I'll take these two accounts because we have inputted historical rate, average rate, and ending rate. If you remember, in your exchange rate table, we are having average, ending, historical, back balance method. In that, we have inputted only for average and ending. So from account dimension, I'm considering average and ending rates. Okay. Average, year, budget, period. Say period, I am going to take all the periods. I'll take version, currency, entity. So beginning balance I am going to remove. Take all this. Okay. So these are, say, quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, quarter, I'm going to four. Okay, but still I am not able to see my this thing. The no access on this thing, because we are trying to look with P4. Let me connect as admin. Now our concentration is to see where our exchange rates are available. Still I am not able to see my data here, but where my data will be available at in this HSP rate. So let me say zoom in, and let me say zoom in. So whatever rate you are inputting with Canada, Euro, GBP, INR and USD are getting logged and sent on this particular data. For Canada you have inputted some value. For Europe, you have inputted some value. For GBP, you have inputted some value. For INR, you have inputted some value. And for USD, you have inputted some value. So where these combinations are available? So what is this input value and what is this input currency value? And what is this HSP rate? HSP rate is your dimension name. So let me keep only this things. Keep only. So this is where your exchange rates are available. The exchange rates ekkada dorukutayi ante at a top level of version, top level of currency, top level of entity, and on each and every month level, and across the particular HSP rates underscore entity or currency type, Canada currency type, Euro currency type, GBP currency type, INR currency type, USD currency type. All these currencies are available here. All your exchange rates are available at this top level. Where are we defining user defined currency? These are application defined currencies. Okay? All these currencies are in your planning application. So even if you want to update your currency rates, you can update from here also. But if you update this currency exchange rate, whenever you do a database refresh, your exchange rate will be overwritten. Okay. Okay. So from security to, we have come into your exchange rates. Okay. where your exchange rates are available. So from this you are able to understand where your exchange rates are available in your SBS database. Though your platform exchange rates are available in exchange rate table, from SBS point of view they are available at this position. Okay, so from security point of view, now we have defined security at data form level and dimension level. Next thing is, let me log in as admin. Password. And next thing we need to discuss is security point of view, we are clear right now. And next thing we need to discuss is, we need to discuss about your business rules. After discussing your business rules, I'll go into task list, menus, user variables, copy data, clear set data. Let us discuss about these things right now. Let us complete this copy data. Now, what I want to do is, in this particular actual form, budget form I think we have created. So, I want to copy my data that is present on this particular January account 01 local to account 03 February. Now my requirement is, I want to copy data that is present on my local of India that is present on January of account 01 to account 03. Okay, so for that, what I can do, I can write a calculation script. Instead of writing calculation script, they have provided you some option called as copy data. When you select this option, okay. So budget is common in this because it is a budget form. So I'll take scenario into consideration and I'll put budget. So both the means source and destination, it has to have a common point called as budget, and at the same time year it was FY11, I think FY11 or FY12, FY12. Let us take it. Okay. Say from accounts point of view, from which account you want to transfer? From account 01 to account 0. Just we are selecting these options. Okay. From period January to submit February. I can even type it February. And from version, BUI version, I think, right? So it is common in both the things. I'll say version BUI version. And from currency, that is local currency, right? Say from entity, it has to copy from all, for all entities. So I'm not going to give this particular entity related information. And on what database it has to perform? It has to perform on this particular expense database. I'll say copy. Let's say entity, add dimension, entity. I want all the members, descendants of. Now if I say copy data, what happens? It will copy my data that is present on this particular combination to your February. Let us go and see that particular one. So whatever data is present on this particular members is getting copied to your account 0132, 100, 100, 100, 100. All this data has been copied. But if you see in this, it didn't copy this particular supporting detail from your January to February. Now what I want even my supporting details also to be copied. I'll go to copy details, and in this I'll say copy supporting details. When I select this copy supporting details, and if I say copy data, let me open this performance. Now even here, supporting details are being copied. So why this particular copy data is available here means, just for the sake of copying your supporting details and your cell text level information. Say if I want to put any text in this, select this option and I'll put a text. This value is due and I'll say support. So now this particular cell is having a text. This cell text is this is the mark. Besides that, there will be something like as comment. So now if I want to read this, I'll just click on this. It'll display my cell text. Sorry. Select this and I'll select this cell text. I'll be able to see this particular cell text. Now if I want to copy this cell text also onto this, say from business rule or a calculation script, I can copy only data, but I cannot copy my supporting details or cell text. So for that, what we are doing is we are using this particular option. Copy data, even copy my cell text. I'll say copy data. Okay. So let us open our web form. If you see, even your cell text is getting copied. Only for the sake of copying your supporting details and your cell text, they have provided this particular option called as copy data. Not for data copy, but mostly this is meant for your cell text and supporting details copy. Same ways, you have something called as clear cell details. When you want to clear cell details, specifically this clear is used only to clear your supporting details or cell text or annotation or cell level documents, anything you have. Only for that purpose you are using it. Say I want to clear accounts. In accounts, which account is having? Account, let us say, wildly let me take all these four options. I don't know whether I have data or not. I say submit. Let me take period. As February. I want to clear only on February and from year FY11. Sorry, FY12. And from scenario, let me take budget. Okay, remaining things I am setting as it is. If I want to delete my supporting details and cell text, I say clear. Confirmation it is asking, I'll say where is this? Okay. So the cell level details have been successfully cleared. Let us see if there is something. So February, even your January, total data is gone on your supporting detail has also been gone on your February. So this is how you can clear your data from cell text and supporting details. Mostly this clear is used for your clearing your cell details, mostly supporting details and cell level text. For that purpose we will be using this. So the remaining things that we have is business rules, workflow and your task list, menus, user variables and workflow. Only these options we are having. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. If we complete these 5 topics, your planning will be done. Monday we will be completing these 5 topics. We will stop for today. So clearly we have seen today about your security. So why this managed security filter is given means, say for example, only one filter is added onto a new member. Say dimension level, what you did, you went into this particular account and you have changed this particular user access, edit access, you made him as read. I'll say set close. Okay, instead of doing this entire database refresh, what I'll do is I'll go to manage security filter and I'll say refresh only P1. Only P1 will be created. Instead of disturbing all the users, I will be disturbing only P1. This way also I can do security refresh when I want to update individual users. But these users will be displayed only when you do, say if a new user is coming called Bargo. If he want to have access on this database, though you provide security on shared services, you have to completely do this security request. Then only you will get this particular user. A user, new user, when he'll be available here? Whenever you do a complete
delete.
Yes. If I want to delete this P1, what I have to do? I have to deprovision him, do sync native directory, and then do a complete database refresh. Select this security and say refresh. Okay. Simultaneously, you can do both the activities. You can do a database refresh and you can do a security refresh. Both the things you can do. But always, I have some users always. So always try to do a security refresh individually and do a database refresh individually. Don't do both at a
time.
Right, always. You have to drop it. But if it is in non-business hours, you need not do it. Saturday, Sundays or off business time. Yes, yes, yes. You will be doing it on daily basis and you will be doing that off business times. Not in a regular business times, you will be doing off business times. Say if it is a US user, all this time is a available time. Mostly whoever is available in that particular shift will be doing the security. So let us log out and we will see into smart view also, how to use smart view. That one area is left. So exchange rates ekkada store aitayo telusu kada, exchange rates will be stored at a top level of version dimension, at a top level of currency dimension, at a top level of entity dimension. But from account dimension, you will be having HSP average and HSP ending. If you have historical, if you have beginning balance, all those informations will be available. But right now in our application, we are taking only average and ending. Same ways, at a year, say in that, if you have filled your exchange rate table with all the years, all year tables will be available. And wherever you are updating, on what scenario you are updating, budget scenario, no, actual scenario, no, that you have to specify. And your currencies you have to mention from your HSP rates table. So why your HSP rates is used means HSP rates dimension is used to store your exchange rates. Exchange rates ni store cheskodam kosam we are using your HSP rates, HSP underscore rates. Okay, stop for today. రేపు వస్తుడా అదే పనిగా వచ్చేది త్రీ పాయింట్ ఫోర్ 3 ఇయర్స్ కదా రైట్